You know, yours, even if it's a banger. And when we were kids, we used to have these Jacksons. You know, you will get up on a Sunday morning and you will throw it. And you will pull it. Why? Because it's mine. Yeah? You put it behind it, you put pounds over time. It's mine. Because it's connected with me, it becomes special, it becomes something different. His children. Again, it means nothing. You may show some affection and love because they are human beings. But you know, when it comes to my children, when it comes to my own son and my own daughter, soot is the connection because it's mine. I will give my life for my own kids. And I will do anything for my own kids. Now look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. Yeah, they are not servants. Allah is saying, my yaqulu ibadi, they are my servants. What are my servants saying? Allah is acknowledging that you are His. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing this, and if you and I are prepared to do anything for something that belongs to us, then what do you think the arhamur rahimin, the akramul akramin? The one is the most merciful out of all the merciful. What do you think the Lord of the earth and kursi is prepared to do for you? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He asks this question, the angels reply, "Ya Allah, yusabbihuna wa yukabbiruna wa yumajjiduna." Ya Allah, they are sitting there, they are glorifying You, they are praising You, they are exalting You, they are saying, "Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, and Allah is the greatest, and Allah is the greatest." And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked the angels, "Had ra'awni, are these people that sit there in the Jami Masjid al-Salaam? They are glorifying me, they are praising me, are they exalting me? But do they really know who I am? Have they ever seen me? Do they truly know of my glory and of my power? Or of my supremeness?" And the angel replied in one word, "Ya Allah, ma ra'uka, they have never seen you." Or that they truly don't know. And Allah asked, "What if they were to see me? Even if it was for a zillionth of a second, what would become of them people? What if they were to truly know what my real power is? What would become of them?" And the angels replied, "إِلَا رَأَوْكَ كَانُوا أَشَدَّ لَكَ عِبَادَةً وَأَكْثَرَ لَكَ تَمْجِيدًا وَأَكْثَرَ لَكَ تَسْبِيحًا." Oh Allah, if they truly knew you, and if they ever saw you, even if it was for a zillionth of a second, then they would spend their entire lives glorifying you, praising you, exalting you. The only words that would flow from their lips would be, "Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Indeed, Allah is the greatest." They would be mesmerized. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then asked the second question. "Ma yas'aluni?" What did they come for? What's the aim and objective? Why are they gathered in that masjid? What are they asking for? And the angels replied, "Ya Allah, yas'aluna fil jannah." They're asking you for this thing called paradise, this thing called jannah. And Allah again asked the same question. Have these guys ever seen paradise? Have they ever seen the لَبِنَةٌ مِنْ ذَهَدٍ وَلَبِنَةٌ مِنْ ذِبَّةٍ وَمَلَاتُهَا الْمِسْكُ الْأَصْفَرُ وَحِذَاءُهَا اللُّؤْلُؤُ وَالْيَاقُوتُ وَتُرْبَتُهَا الزَّعْفَرَانُ؟ Have they ever seen the bricks of gold and silver paradise is made out of? Bricks of gold, and then there's a brick of silver, and then there's a brick of gold, and then there's a brick of silver. Now these bricks of gold and silver are joined together with not your sand and cement. It is a mixture made out of rubies, diamonds, and emeralds. This is what the bricks of gold and silver are joined with. Have they ever seen this? Have they ever seen the trees of paradise? The trunks are not out of wood. The trunks are out of gold and different materials. وَقُتُوتُهَا دَانِيَةً. And the fruit of these trees is vine. And there are pomegranates. And there are guavas. And then there are grapes. And then there are apples. And then there are pears. And then there is the beautiful Pakistani hunger which you and I crave and desire? Have you ever seen the palaces of paradise? Palaces made out of rubies, palaces made out of pearls, palaces made out of diamonds. And then the Wahoor al-Mu'min Ka'ansari, Nukhuri al-Masnoon. And have you ever seen the Huri'in of paradise? إِنَّا نْشَأْنَهُنَّ إِنْشَاءً فَجَعَلْنَهُنَّ أَجْيَارًا قُرُبَ الْأَجْرَابًا. It is a different creation. No eye has ever seen these beautiful creations before. The human mind cannot even conceive of this creation. Have you ever seen this? Have you ever seen these rivers? فِيهَا نَهَارٌ مِنْ مَاءٍ غَيْرِ آسِنٍ وَنَهَارٌ مِنْ لَبَنٍ لَمْ يَتَغَيَّرْ طَعْمُهُ وَنَهَارٌ مِنْ خَمْرِ لَذَّةٍ لِلشَّارِبِينَ. There are rivers of water which is not polluted like the rivers of England. There are rivers of milk, pure, beautiful, white milk which does not go off. Have you seen the rivers of wine which is delicious for the drinkers and they can drink as much as they please and they will never get a headache. And that like يصدعون عنها ولا ينزفون. And they will not get drunk. Have they seen the rivers of honey? Have they seen these blessings? The angels replied, "Oh Allah, they've never seen your paradise. They've never seen your blessings." Allah asked, "What if these people were to see these blessings, then what would become of them?" And the angels replied, "Oh Allah, if they were to ever see these blessings, كانوا أشد لك عبادة وأكثر لك تمجيدا وأكثر لك. Oh Allah, they would praise you even more. Oh Allah, they would worship you even more. Oh Allah, they would spend their entire lives begging you for this paradise and they would refrain from disobeying you or going against any one of your commands and rules." Allah asked the final question. What are they asking protection from? And the angels replied in one voice. To Allah, they are asking protection from Jahannam. And Allah again asked the same question. Have these people ever seen Jahannam? Have they ever seen the fire of hell, which is hotter than any fire of this world? Have they ever seen the snakes and the scorpions of Jahannam? Have they ever seen the different tortures and punishments of Jahannam? And the angels of Ibrahim will worship Allah with Muhammad. Allah asked, what would become of these people if they were to see Jahannam? Even if it was just for one zillionth of a second, just one glimpse, what would become of these people? And the angels replied, "Oh Allah, if they were to ever see your Jahannam, one glimpse, oh Allah, they would become so terrified. So terrified, oh Allah, in their entire life, not once would they ever disobey you. Oh Allah, not once would they go against any teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No once would they go against any teaching of the Quran. Oh Allah, this is what they would become of them, and they would spend their entire life asking you to protect them from Jahannam and the fire of hell." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to these angels, say, "Oh my angels, إِنِّي أُشْهِدُكُمْ أَنِّي تَبْخَطَرُكُمْ." I want you to bear witness today that all those guys that were participating in that blessed gathering of September in the Jami Masjid of Salah, I want you to bear witness that I've forgiven every single one of them. The learned, the non-learned, the old, the young, and even the toddlers that didn't even understand one word. Every one of them I have forgiven. And the angels asked, "You Allah, you know what? There was a guy sitting in that gathering. Jahannam had his name. He came with a different intention. He didn't come to listen to the words of Allah, his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He came for some other reason. Maybe at 6 o'clock he had an argument with his wife. And she kicked him out of the house. Now this big guy has got nowhere to go. And he saw people coming to the masjid. So he thought, let me come to this gathering, maybe there's some food afterwards. So inside the masjid for a few hours, till about Isha. By that time, till I've cooled down, I'll have a nice bite to eat,
And then I'll go back home. So he came for a different reason. His intention was not the words of Allah and the Rasul. And he sat in that gathering for that reason. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, هُمَ الْقَوْمُ لَا يَشْقَ بِهِمْ جَلِيسُهُمْ. See, that gathering is so blessed. And those people that were participating in that gathering, they are so blessed and so special in my eyes, that even that one person that did not come with the right intention, that did not come to listen to the words of Allah and the Rasul, as a result of those people and their blessedness, I have forgiven him. He is over. How blessed do you think you are? And how blessed do you think this gathering is?